keeping our eyes open for wildlife.
It's bread and butter and sugar, fried and sweet and crunchy and a little soft and creamy too.
Good morning from Surat Thani, Thailand. We're on our way to Koh Samui, which if you didn't know is an island off the coast of Thailand. Beautiful island, by the way. Most people that are traveling to Samui stop over in Surat Thani after a plane or train ride overnight. Then they grab the ferry the next day and head over to the island. We decided to take a little bit more time here. We're spending several days visiting the city, trying to just get an idea of what life is like here, visiting some local sites. And the first thing we're gonna do is get on a boat. So let's go and do that. Not sure if that came through on the audio, but we're starting to hear a lot of fireworks going off. Chinese New Year is just around the corner, and I don't know if people are testing their fireworks or what, but we're definitely hearing a lot of activity.
It's early in the morning, so it's nice and cool. But also, we've been in Bangkok and city and busy and busy, busy, and this is the complete opposite of that, and it's so nice and refreshing.
We're keeping our eyes open for wildlife. Yesterday, we saw two huge monitor lizards. Apparently, they can get up to 6.5 feet here. I think the ones we saw were like 7 feet, but Stephanie told me they're more like 3 or 4 feet, and that's probably true. But they were really, really large, so we're gonna keep our eyes open to see if we see any other aquatic life in this area. I'm curious, if you're from Thailand, is this something you would come and do? Or is this something that only Westerners find interesting? I mean, it seems pretty cool regardless of where you're from. This is very cool, the way these palms are growing across the slough or canal. I don't know what it's called, but it's pretty cool. Obviously, this is a motorboat, but our captain periodically is turning off the motor so we can just sort of coast along. We are seeing lots of monitor lizards here. I don't think we're doing it justice with the video, primarily because we don't really have zoom lenses. They tend to be pretty shy and run away as we get close, but it's really cool. We're just not used to seeing reptiles that are so big, so it's kind of fun for us. And here we are making our way back in to the main river, heading back to dock. I think that's gonna conclude the boat tour, which was really cool. I think well worth the money that we spent.
And it wasn't that much.
Really fun. So we just finished our boat tour and it was so cool, so nice. But I think what really made it special was the couple that we hired were like so nice. Just really nice. There were some places down the pier where there was kind of high pressure.
And very kind of aggressive.
Yeah, aggressive. But we just sort of, I think, kind of...
We just walked up the pier a little bit and she approached us and she's very friendly, very nice, no pressure. And we arranged it, came back the next morning, and here we are.
So if you're here, you definitely want to book this tour. It was 400 baht for an hour, which I think is very reasonable. We're going to put their contact information in the description below, and we will drop a pin for the location because it's just sort of on the pier. And hopefully you can find them. Super nice couple, and we'll roll some b-roll so you can see what they look like.
Well, we're pretty thirsty now, a bit warm, so we're gonna go get something to drink.
Cheers, babe.
Yeah.
I will edit out the expletives, but that was quite loud. We're not quite sure if Chinese New Year starts today, February 9th, or the 10th. So it seems like there are a lot of celebrations going on, and a lot of really large offerings that are out on the street. We can see people are putting together these pretty large offerings. So it's kind of cool, but we're just not sure if this is like an eve or if it started.
So we just got a drink at Neat Espresso, and there was a beautiful offering outside when we walked in, and we weren't there very long. And when we left, the woman who was there gave us part of the offering. It was so sweet.
So now that we've cooled off a little bit with the drink, we're gonna go walk around the city and explore a little bit. For lunch, we found this restaurant called Fyre Homie that looked really unique. Unfortunately, I forgot to turn off my microphone, so our audio is garbled. I ordered a dish with pork and chicken and what appears to be little crisps. I ordered the dish at Thai spice level, so I wasn't quite sure what to expect. It turns out the dish was amazing. Definitely spicy, like lip-numbing spicy, but very unique and enjoyable.
It's very spicy. It's got some peanuts. It's a really nice broth, and I think I'm really going to enjoy this.
I'm not exactly sure what Stephanie got, but it's some kind of rice dish with chicken and egg and pork. Oh, no chicken. Pork. Just pork. And it looks really good. So we just finished lunch at Fyre Homie, and let me tell you, my mouth is on fire. It is so hot, the spicy version of the food, but I really enjoyed it. It was like this really different flavor. I have no idea what I ate, but it was kind of a noodle soup. Amazing. Definitely come here if you're visiting Surat Thani. Well, it's the middle of the day, it's super hot. We're gonna head back to our hotel, get some work done, and head out a little bit later for dinner. Okay, so we are back out on the town. Got a little bit of work done. We booked one future location for two nights. And I got almost nothing done on our video editing for some reason. But the good news is we are heading to the Surat Thani night market, which is really cool. We checked it out briefly last night, and now we're excited to actually try some of the food because it all looked amazing. So let's go.
We were at the night market last night just looking around. We found a lot of really great things that we wanted to try tonight. So we're back, and then I got, and I know everyone's gonna roll their eyes at me, I got two pieces of sushi, They were 10 baht each. We got a delicious looking banana thing and some fried mushrooms with some tom yum spice on them, which I am really excited to try. So let's dig in. Oh, it's pretty good. Oh, ooh, that's spicy.
Okay, so we have this fried mushroom thing that looks really good. Oh, it's spicy, really crispy, tastes really good, really well seasoned. I hate to say it, reminds me a little bit of Doritos, but that's kind of insulting to the flavor. It's really good. So the good thing about the night market is it's like a buffet. If you're hungry, you can just keep going back until you're full. We have one last thing, but I think we're gonna go back again, and that is this banana, I don't know what it is, a banana, like a fried banana in a like a syrupy sauce. Oh, that's really good. I think it's condensed milk. Really good. I love this.
By the way, the mushrooms did not taste like Doritos. They tasted like a delicious chili, lime, crispy mushroom delicious.
So I picked up these little balls of dough with a filling inside. I had four. I just ate one because I couldn't wait. They're basically filled with like seafood. So shrimp, octopus in one of them, I think some seaweed in one of them, and some fish eggs in the other. I don't know which is which. There's no label on them, but there's a little sauce that they gave me. So I'm gonna try one and we'll see how it is. Oh. I have no idea what that is. It tastes like a little pancake that's wrapped around something. It's pretty good, but I suggest we keep going. Check out what else is here to eat. Okay, so we have finished our night market adventure. We picked up a couple of desserts and we're actually heading over to the river to check out the Lunar New Year
festivities,
I guess you would call them. So let's go check them out. I'm not sure if it's clear or not, but today is, I think, the first day that they're celebrating Lunar New Year or Chinese New Year. And they've got this whole area decorated out by the river. And we wanted to come out tonight because all the families are out, and it's kind of cool to just see everybody out enjoying the cool breeze, nighttime air, and we're just going to walk around a little bit.
Yeah, it's really pretty with all the lights.
So I'm going to have one of these little dessert tacos now. They have historically been very good, where I've had them before, but I haven't tried these yet, so let's give them a try. Very good. And I have a whole bag.
So one of the dessert things I got was a roti with condensed milk, and they made it fresh right in front of us. And it's cooled down a little bit, so it won't hopefully burn my face off when I eat it, but we're gonna give it a try now.
And here's one more reason you should always carry Kleenex or an extra napkin with you when you travel.
And we almost forgot, they have a really nice fruit market here that we went to on our first day. We didn't take any video, but bought some fruit there and it was fantastic.
We've had a really busy and really great day today, full of really fun things, but now it's time to call it a night and go get some sleep. We'll see you tomorrow.
So we just stopped at this little place called Wa for a morning pick-me-up as we're headed over to look at a couple temples. It's very warm out. So we got a little croissant with some matcha chestnut topping, which is very, very fancy. And then we got a couple of drinks as well that look amazing. So I got a drink with red bean, milk, and matcha.
Came with a spoon.
With a spoon. And Stephanie got a latte, so a nice latte.
Yeah.
It looks beautiful though, so you should show it for everyone. Yes, and now we're going to enjoy this because it's very fancy.
And very, very fancy.
And we needed something very fancy this morning.
So we're going to try this green, it almost looks like angel hair pasta, the way they've extruded it onto top of the croissant. Oh. I'm actually surprised how much I like that. I'm normally not a huge matcha fan, but it's really mild. And the Japanese chestnuts give it kind of like this underlying sweet and mildly nutty flavor. It's actually really, really good.
All right, I'm going to try it. Oh, that's really good. Mild matcha. I wouldn't call it sweet at all. Wow. Really nice consistency is the word. Yeah, the mouth feels really smooth. This is going to be good.
I think so.
That was a perfect Lunar New Year fancy breakfast. Now it's time to go out and explore the city.
You should definitely come to Wa when you're in Surat Thani. Really great.
I'm not sure what I was expecting, but the quality of the coffee shops here has
really
been
great. Really
great. Like, I'm really surprised how much I've been enjoying our little coffee breaks. So we wanted to come over and check out Wat Klong Khao. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. The city has highlighted several, I guess, sort of historical points of interest on these plaques, and we've kind of been following them around. And this is one of the historical points of interest that they highlighted. So we thought we'd come over today and kind of check it out because it's a really, really beautiful temple. From what we read, this is one of the earliest temples in Surat Thani. It was likely founded prior to 1777. In 1889, King Rama V reportedly stopped here and visited and donated 40 baht to the restoration of part of the temple.
So I went inside and it's very peaceful, just like you would expect out of a temple, and really beautiful, and they're just so serene when you're inside, so it's nice, at least for me, just to go in and take a moment and have a breath, and it was really, really nice.
So we went back to the hotel because it was super, super hot outside, took a break, actually did a bunch of work, and got some logistics planned for our travel. Now we're out heading to the Saturday night market. Now it's Lunar New Year, so we're not actually sure if any markets are open tonight, but the Saturday night market's supposed to be really cool, so we're gonna go see what's out there. Well, the good news is it looks like the market is open. Lots of activity down here on the pier.
Walking through the night market here, there is a ton of food here. I mean, it just keeps going on and on and on down the street. And we saw this guy making potatoes with some corn and cheese. So I decided I needed to get one because I haven't had a potato in a while. And he got them straight off the grill, mixed them up, put some things in it, may have put some condensed milk in it. I am not sure, but we'll give it a try. So it's potato, cheese, and corn. Ooh.
Big bite.
It's hot.
It's a big bite.
That's so good. I think it's mozzarella cheese. And he put some Italian seasoning on it. And it's delicious. And now I have to share it with Chris, but I think there's enough for both of us.
Okay, so I'm gonna give this a try now. I was very concerned about whatever they were putting in here that looked like condensed milk. Stephanie says she's not sure what it was. I think I'm going to take a smaller bite than she took because that looked really hot and uncomfortable. But here goes. That is good. That is very good. I have no idea what's in it, but it's very good. Definitely good tie marks for me. So I just picked up a few things, and or a couple of things, and one is a very messy looking pork skewer that looks quite delicious. It's got a pepper on it, I think a tomato, and then some kind of spicy sauce that's probably gonna burn my face off. Oh, that's really good. Mm. Wow.
Is that burning your face off?
No. It's mildly spicy. Then I got some shrimp on a skewer, and I don't know how you eat these, so I'm just gonna eat it. Pretty good. I liked it if it was a little warmer, but pretty good. I don't know if I'm supposed to eat the whole thing. You can see there are a ton of people out tonight behind me. Lots and lots of people out enjoying the outdoors, eating, it looks like, having their delicious Thai smoothies, which I'm thinking about right now. It's a really great night, and the temperature is amazing, so we're really, really happy. Tonight is better than we could have expected.
So after that food, we needed something to drink, so of course we got a coconut smoothie, which was really great, and I love that they're very clever and they've got a great way to carry them around, which is really nice, helps free up your hands a little bit. And then we saw this other place making, I wish she was making like these little pancake type things. They look a little bit like hats when they're cooking. We're gonna try those now, and they were super fresh just out of the oil, so we're gonna give it a try. Oh, these are really yummy, fried and sweet and crunchy and a little soft and creamy too. Really good.
So Stephanie's still eating hers behind the camera. I'm like, let me try. This is super hot. Like, I'm actually afraid I'm gonna burn myself because this one is a little bit less, like my hand is actually burning. Let me just sample, nibble. Really good. Mine's still too hot to like really bite into, but good choice, Chris. So we did try to Google Translate what these were, and it said something like ancient Thai milk. So clearly that has some relation to what these are. If you know what they are, we'd be really interested to know. You can drop us a note in the comments.
This is turning out to be such a great Saturday night market. we've been to quite a few so far. We've been very lucky. And this one has just had things we haven't seen, and I think we're getting a little bit more adventurous and just saying, hey, that looks good and let's try it, even if we're maybe not quite sure exactly what it is. So we found a couple more things. I think they're two dessert things, and the first one, I think honestly it's bread and butter and sugar, and he grilled it, and this one is literally fresh off of the grill. So that's like cinnamon sugar toast without the cinnamon, and it's really, really good. Okay. And then we got this other thing, and it looks like, can you hold that? Again, not exactly sure. I mean, it's rice of some sort. I don't know if it's the rice from Mango Sticky Rice, but it's like, I don't want to say, I mean, maybe it's pan fried, I'm not exactly sure, but it looks so good. I love crispy rice. Again, this was really hot, so let's see. Ooh. Oh my God. It's crispy mango sticky rice. Oh my God, it is so delicious. I literally may not share this with Chris. It's like my favorite thing, 10 times better.
So first off, I'm going to try the cinnamon toast bread without cinnamon. Oh, wow. Yeah. That is special. All these amazing things. And we just keep stumbling onto them.
Again, if you know what it is, tell us.
All right. Now, I somehow have to get some of that crispy mango sticky rice. All right, I got a small piece. Really nice. Kind of want my own. What a nice night. Really cool. We're so fortunate. This has been an amazing, amazing trip. And we still have one day left at Surat Thani, so I'm really glad. We decided to just come to this place, which not a lot of people go to, and explore, and it's been very, very rewarding. So behind me is a 100-year-old wooden sermon pavilion. We've been eating right outside here for the past couple of nights at the night market, and we thought we should come by and take a look. So that's what we're gonna do.
Located next to the night market, the Wat Sai Museum is quite small, but almost every display includes an English translation. The museum houses a number of ancient relics along with historical documents and photographs.
So we had an amazing night tonight. What a great night market. In fact, we ended up walking through three night markets, which is kind of incredible. It may have been an extra special night because it's Lunar New Year and there were a lot of people out in kind of traditional outfits. Really cool to see that. And we had some amazing food. It's getting late though. Time for us to head back and get some rest.
So today is our last full day here in Surat Thani. We've been having a great time, but there's a few things we haven't seen yet, like the City Pillar Shrine. So that's where we're headed now. The shrine behind me was built in 1782 by King Rama I to bring prosperity to the city of Surat Thani. And from what we can see, I think it succeeded.
Because we are nearby, we thought we would go take a walk over to Koh Lampu. I think I'm pronouncing that. Well, I'm pronouncing it as best I can, which is a little island park in the middle of the river. So Stephanie just asked me what's over here, and honestly, I have no idea. Other than it's supposed to be just a nice place to walk and maybe get outside the city, just sort of relaxing. And since we were nearby, I thought it made sense to at least stop by and check it out. And here we go, we found a map that answers all of our questions. So I think we're over here and let's just walk around the perimeter here. Yeah, I'm liking this park. Really nice trail we're on. Although, the river seems very high today. I guess this is the end of the trail. I'm trying to figure out what these little fruits are that are growing on these palm trees. They don't look like coconut palms to me.
But if you can tell us what kind of palm trees they are or what kind of fruit it's on it, I don't know if it's for making palm oil. I have no idea. Please let us know.
So it looks like we found the other part of the trail. Interesting, the tide looks like it's coming in and you can actually see the water kind of coming in right behind us.
Who knew that watching the river rise was some hungry work? Now it's time to go get some lunch.
So for lunch, we came to this really cool cafe right on the river called Kram Cafe. They have kind of traditional cafe food. So we're gonna have lunch here. We've got a couple of iced teas. Looks good. So I got steamed rice with a shrimp omelet, and Stephanie got a ham and cheese soft omelet over steamed rice. Looks really good. We're gonna dig in now. That omelet is so creamy. I don't know how they make these omelets, but so delicious.
We just finished a delicious lunch and have come to the end of our time here in Surat Thani. I'm so glad we decided to stay for a couple of days before moving on, and you should too if you're going to be in the area. The city has so much to offer, great markets, beautiful things to see, nice wats. Spend some time here, you'll really enjoy it. If you liked seeing Surat Thani with us, please give us a thumbs up and consider subscribing. We'll see you in the next one.
Uh-oh. I think this is where we cut.